ESPN welcomes you to the following presentation of the National Football League.
Back in Baltimore to start the 43rd season of Monday Night Football, the first Monday Night Football game played in 1970 that was hosted by the Cleveland Browns. Their owner, Art Modell, was instrumental in making the concept of Monday Night Football a reality. From TV to labor negotiations to championing minority hires, Art Modell impacted the legacy of the NFL far beyond the controversial move of the Browns from Cleveland to here in Baltimore. His death on Thursday had a profound impact on the city and the Ravens team he once owned, and Lisa Salters has more on that. Lisa?
Well, Mike, here in Baltimore, Art Modell was truly beloved for filling the void that was left when the Colts left town in the middle of the night. At a public viewing here on Saturday, thousands filed into the stadium to pay their respect and to give their condolences to the Modell family. And here tonight, players will wear decals with Modell's initials on their helmets. One player in particular who is mourning the loss of Art Modell, Ray Lewis, who first met Modell when he was just 19 years old. Lewis, along with teammates Ed Reed, Haloti Ngata, and head coach John Harbaugh, went to the hospital to see Modell one last time the day before he died. Lewis told me it was a moment he will always cherish. He said Modell wasn't able to talk, but he could respond with his eyes and was aware of who was in the room. Lewis said he bent down and spoke to Modell in his ear. What I told him, he said, will always be between me and him, but it was what a son would share with a father. From my heart, I wanted him to know what he meant to me, Lewis said, before he closed his eyes for good. Mike?
Lisa, the folks who were there shared some of their personal moments. It was a very heartwarming moment. Let's join the public address announcer here at M&T Bank Stadium now. Here's Bruce Cunningham.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, we ask you to rise at this time to honor the life of Art Modell with a moment of silence followed by our national anthem. Thank you, Art. We love you.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Make your hair stand on end moments here in Baltimore, and the emotion of the Ravens and their fans remembering Art Modell, and he transitioned to a football game. And John, we watched all the week one football games together, and I know for you there's an angst, and every coach is a little different pit in your stomach week one because of the unknown. What's it like for these coaches right now?
Oh, they're very excited. They got a lot of new players on their team. They have a lot of new coaches, a lot of new schemes, and as you said, a lot of unknown. But at the end of the day, an opportunity to win a division, be great. There's a lot of excitement going through these coaches' veins right now.
Especially Marvin Lewis, who, as we mentioned before, had been here in Baltimore. He shared his recollections of Art Modell with us yesterday. Marvin Lewis, third longest tenured coach in the National Football League behind Andy Reid and Bill Belichick. Over there on the Cincinnati sideline, and on the other side, just a guy who's shown up and wins and wins and wins. John Harbaugh, 4 years, been to the playoff all 4 years. He turns 50 in a couple of weeks and would like to see his 50th birthday be another victory. They play the Patriots in a couple. Very tough start to the season just in terms of scheduling for the Ravens. They have 3 primetime games out of their first 4. Toss won by Baltimore, and they will receive to start this 2012 season. Bengals solid place kicker with Mike Nugent. His kicks plus the coverage of the Bengals special teams led to toughest average start for the Cincinnati opponents. Deontay Thompson back deep to receive. The rookie for the Ravens. Monday night doubleheader, season 43 of Monday Night Football. And off we go from Baltimore. It'll be Thompson going forward from 5 deep. And he'll bring it out to the 21-yard line. Joe Flacco and the Raven offense, they promise no huddle. We'll watch. It's been very good for Joe Flacco. Most in NFL history. Quarterback in his first 4 seasons. Those 44 regular season wins. He and Matt Ryan came in about the same time. They have been very solid to start their career. With no huddle, more responsibility for Flacco. We'll see how quickly they jump in to the tempo. 21, it's play action. Flacco hit as he throws downfield for Torrey Smith. Held on to the 30. Marked at the 26. A gain of 52.
Torrey Smith is the guy we've talked about all week. He can fly. Play action pass. They're going to run a post pattern against Leon Hall, and Joe Flacco throws it perfectly. Torrey Smith ran right by Leon Hall. He had no help inside by the safeties because of the play action pass.
Snap from Matt Burke, the Harvard center. The run up the middle with Rice to the 21-yard line. Cam Cameron is the offensive coordinator for this group, John. We know about Rice. We saw the talent of Torrey Smith. They have good tight ends in Ed Dixon and Dennis Pitta, both in their third year. Their questions, what's going on up front with the O-line?
Shuffled the offensive line. Michael Orr is at left tackle. Rookie at right tackle, Kelechi Osemele from Iowa State.
After the gain of 6, 2nd and 4, Flacco throws incomplete in the area of Dennis Pitta.
Go back to the offensive line, Mike. Matt Burke is still there at center. The longtime Harvard graduate anchors this offensive line. Ramon Harewood from Morehouse College is starting tonight at left guard. So there's a lot of change on this Raven offensive line. A rookie, Osemele at right tackle. A bit of an unknown, Harewood at left guard. And Orr is switched to left tackle.
Many thought the ex-Bengal Bobby Williams, just signed this year by Baltimore, would be that left guard. Bengals bring pressure. Flacco hit and brought down. The impact came from Geno Atkins, the Pro Bowl defender, who rolled into Flacco. And the sack will force a field goal attempt.
Geno Atkins, a Pro Bowl defensive tackle from last year out of Georgia, the former fourth rounder, on a stunt, just pushes Matt Burke right into the quarterback. Geno Atkins can play. Not a lot of people across the nation know him. They will after tonight.
There are 4 rookie kickers in the NFL this year. Justin Tucker's one of them. Beat out Billy Cundiff, who had the big miss in the AFC Championship game against New England. First kick from 46. Hook'em Horns, the U Texas alum, knocks it through. Big play on the opening drive. First points of the season for Baltimore.
ESPN's Monday Night Football is brought to you by Bud Light, the official beer sponsor of the NFL. Here we go. Lexus, introducing a stunning work of technology, the entirely new Lexus ES. NFL Fantasy. It's not too late to play. Sign up at NFL.com/fantasy today. And New Era, fly your own flag.
Some of the beautiful shots, the Inner Harbor, been teeming with fans. Yankees and Orioles at a four-game series. There's a pennant race in Baltimore in September. The Ravens open. It's been a great weekend down here in the Inner Harbor area. Opening drive field goal by Justin Tucker. Now, without Billy Cundiff, he was the touchback king of the National Football League over the last couple of years. But with the kickoffs at the 35 and a strong enough leg, Phil Tucker will not be a downgrade in that department. Brandon Tate back deep, and he'll return it from four deep. Tate climbs through the hole and tackled at the 20-yard line by Shockey Brown, backup defensive back. What a year one it was for Andy Dalton out of TCU. Took the Horned Frogs to the Rose Bowl and their biggest prominence in football in about a half century. Drafted early second round, number 35 overall. What'd he do? As a rookie, he did something like Dan Marino had done before. With those stats and wins you saw there. And he'll be dealing with the Raven defense and the noise of this home crowd. First snap from the 21. And the throw is high for A.J. Green. And it's incomplete. John, right away we focus on the center, Jeff Fade.
Well, the reason we focus on him is he just got here. He just signed with the Bengals last week. He's had two padded practices. He's replacing Kyle Cook, who started 50 straight games. Now, I coached Jeff Fain, as my brother Jay did. He has some familiarity with this Bengals system, but the terminology's different. Let's see how he communicates in this noise.
Armand Bins, the rookie receiver in motion. Here's Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis for a couple of yards with Ray Lewis making the tackle. You mentioned your brother, Jay Gruden. He's the offensive coordinator, second year here with the Bengals. And as we look at the Cincinnati offense, Green Ellis is a huge new addition, replacing Cedric Benson.
No question, he can do a lot of things well. One of them is picking up blitzes, and look for Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis to pick up a Raven blitz. This is when Baltimore comes after you, third and long at home in this noise.
Ravens in the nickel. They bring five, and Dalton's pass is deflected and incomplete. Bernard Pollard, the safety, on the pressure with the pass breakup.
Well, Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis just got welcomed to Baltimore by Bernard Pollard on a safety blitz. You're going to see number 42, Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis, stick his face in there. Not good enough. And Bernard Pollard forces a three and out. Good work by this Raven defense.
Kevin Huber had a career best punting season last year. Jacoby Jones acquired from Houston. Back deep to receive. Low kick, bouncing. They'll stay away from it. And not the best effort from Huber. 39 on the kick. Good field position for the Ravens after their defense forces a three and out. Henning, the head coach the last 3 years, fired. And he's hired here now as the quarterback coach. But John, his time around Peyton Manning, a great help as he's now Joe Flacco's position coach.
How would you like to have Jim Caldwell as a resource to you in regards to the no huddle? Nobody can know it better than Jim Caldwell. And Joe Flacco's taken full advantage of Jim Caldwell's background, and it shows early in his game.
Drive starts from the 37, and the guy coming around gets the ball this time. Torrey Smith. goes down a gain of 13. And, John, that's a play that hurt the Bengals last year.
Well, they're going to hand the ball to Ray Rice later in the game. And this reverse right here is to control the backside. If the backside chases Ray Rice, there's nobody there for Torrey Smith. That combination, the reverse to Smith and the handoff to Rice, has killed Cincinnati.
From midfield, play action, Flacco gets rid of the Javonte Leach's fullback across the 40. Another first down. Gain of 11, Michael Johnson with the pressure.
This no huddle has a lot of advantages. You can run more plays. Everybody gets more touches. You accumulate more yards. You can limit the substitutions, the communication of the defense. You regulate the defense, Mike. They can't do as many things. And Baltimore will change the tempo off and on. They'll go fast. They'll slow it down. And Flacco's getting the Ravens in perfect play selection.
From the 40, Anquan Boldin fumbling the handoff, and he falls back on it for a loss of 10. They're trying to set up perhaps a double reverse with Jacoby Jones. But the mishandle by the veteran Boldin.
When you're watching this Raven offense, when the ball is between the 40s, Cam Cameron, the offensive coordinator, very aggressive. He took a shot two plays ago. There's a double reverse. That one backfired. They had a play there if they could execute the ball handling. But when you watch Baltimore, expect aggressive play calling between the 40s.
On second and 20, Flacco throws on the slant, caught by Jacoby Jones, acquired from the Texans. Gain of 5. Terrence Newman made the tackle. He was a corner when Mike Zimmer was the defensive coordinator with the Cowboys. Mike has been with Atlanta as well in Cincinnati 13 years in a row. He's been a defensive coordinator in the NFL.
And he likes defenders that have a pedigree. Look out in that secondary. The names on the back of those corners. Terrence Newman, over 30 career picks. Nate Clemens has over 30. Leon Hall has 20. Adam Jones out there playing. A lot of first rounders, Mike.
Pressure coming as Flacco throws. It's gone for the first down. Again, it's Smith. But Jones this time, beg your pardon, inside the 30 at the 29 for Jacoby.
Well, Jacoby Jones just came over here from Houston. And watch this back shoulder fade by Flacco. Hard to defend. They pick up the blitz. They find one-on-one coverage. And right now, the Ravens have three receivers that can beat one-on-one coverage. Boldin, Torrey Smith, and now you have Jacoby Jones.
And we haven't even talked, John, about their tight ends, Ed Dixon and Dennis Pitta. Again, they hand on the reverse to Anquan Boldin. In the open field, Leon Hall with a good, solid, fundamental play. Only a gain of a couple on the run.
You know, Leon Hall missed 8 games last year with an Achilles. Good to see him back out here, but this is just outstanding football by a corner. Breaking down, form tackling, a great runner in the open field. If you're a modern-day football player, that means active today, you better be able to tackle, Mike, if you're a corner. Great work by Hall.
The 26 will draw action with Ray Rice. He bounces for only about a yard. Nice job by Michael Johnson, his penetration. Only a second carry for Ray Rice. How consistent has he been? Minimum of 1,700 total yards each of the last 3 years. And last year, led the NFL in yards from scrimmage with over 2,000.
It's not just that either. It's the durability, Mike. Every week, Ray Rice is out there, and he never comes off the field. Tremendous stamina and toughness.
Bunch formation to the right. Flacco looks that way. Crossing is Boldin. And a good job to keep inside of the first down by Thomas Howard, the former Raider, second year as a Bengal. Perhaps a second field goal attempt. Let's see what they do.
It's a creative blitz by Mike Zimmer. You're going to see pressure coming off the left side. Ray Rice picks it up. Just a little check down against the picket fence defense. Good tackling. Boldin comes underneath with no fear. He's got to catch his shallow crossing. Fight the split, people. For the first down, didn't get it.
John, fourth down, they're talking about going for it here. One thing Joe Flacco does very, very well is the hard count.
He got Cleveland here last year. The Bengals better be alert for a hard count.
Ravens Flacco late getting organized, so they'll take a timeout halfway through the first. Oakland, where Philip Rivers and the Chargers visit Darren McFadden, Carson Palmer, and the Raiders. Chris Berman, Trent Dilfer have it for you coming up after we're done to wrap up kickoff weekend 2012. John, we talked about Flacco and that hard count here on fourth down.
Listen to see if he draws the Bengals off sides.
They'll go for it on fourth and one, and Flacco rolling and throws for Rice, who made the catch, and since he was untouched, able to roll and get the first down in front of Nate Clemens, the corner.
That's not going to show up on a stat sheet, just a two-yard gain, but what a great catch by Ray Rice. Watch him twist his body, catch his ball away from his body one-handed, and get the first down. Ray Rice can hurt you so many ways. He deserved the contract he just signed, Mike.
He even deserved another half yard on that play. The first down at the 19. Flacco with some time again, nearly threw an interception as it was deflected off the hands of Thomas Howard.
Those are the kind of plays the Bengals need to make. When you get your hands on the football, you have to make those kinds of plays defensively. Flacco rarely turns the ball over in the red zone. Got a little careless there.
Second and 10, 5 in the pattern for Flacco, who throws complete to Dennis Pitt of the tight end. First and goal for the Ravens. Caught one ball as a rookie. 40 receptions last year.
What impresses me is the pass protection. A lot of new linemen. Michael Orr at left tackle. Harewood at left guard. Joe Flacco has plenty of time to sit back here in the pocket and find the open receiver. It's just a nice outside breaking route. Ball's thrown well. A lot of weapons.
Quick count. It is Rice to the right, to the end zone. Touchdown, Ravens.
Ravens are wearing Cincinnati out with tempo. Different personnel groupings. That time, a two-back set, and Vontae Leach, the Pro Bowl fullback. Watch it coming right into your living room. Watch the fullback, Vontae Leach, escort Ray Rice to daylight. I don't think he got touched.
So good on those cuts. Touchdown number 30. Fantasy football owners across America very happy. Extra point added by Tucker. What a first 9 minutes of the season for the Ravens and their offense. Two nice drives, some big plays, fourth down pickups, and paid off, as usual, by the little man from Rutgers, Ray Rice. Season, only three plays run by the Bengals in the first 9 minutes. And a field goal and a touchdown for Baltimore. And Marvin Lewis over there talking to Manny Lawson and the rest of the defense. Got to pick it up and stop these guys. Tate takes it on the bounce. Cedric Pierman told him, don't bring it out. He chose to. He made a mistake.
Boy, that's a terrible mistake by a veteran returner. Tate has returned way too many balls to make a mistake like that and put your offense inside the 10. You have to have a clock in your head. You have to listen to the other return man. Stay in the end zone. Careless mistake on special teams by Brandon Tate.
Well covered by the Ravens and Sean Considine. So Andy Dalton and company up against it already. Backed up at their own 8. Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis, running them out of the shadows of the goalpost. Went for a couple of yards to the 10. That Raven defense with a 10-point lead, pretty jacked up. John Green Ellis comes in. We mentioned replacing Cedric Benson, who had 3,000-yard seasons. Green Ellis, 1,000 yards in 2010, and very productive and dependable for Bill Belichick in New England.
The only problem is he's missed the last 3 preseason games. He's had injury problems throughout training camp, as have a lot of these Bengal offensive players. Somebody needs to make a play, quiet this crowd, and get some kind of momentum going for the Bengals.
And a flag thrown as the Ravens broke the huddle with 12 players. As you know, the regular officials still locked out by the NFL, so the replacement officials are becoming more full-time now. This is Matt Nix, first name Richard, goes by the nickname Matt.
We have illegal substitution on the defense, 12 men on the field, 5-yard penalty, remains second down.
He's an environmental engineer from Mount Juliet, Tennessee, and has worked lower division college football games in the past. John Harbaugh looks like his brother Jim did most of the San Francisco Green Bay game. Old or new officials, see shirt, chew them out. The second and three, Dalton gets it quickly in the hands of Andrew Hawkins, who gets a first down across the 20-yard line. Ladarius Webb with a tackle.
We look out there on the field.
A scuffle going on the sideline there, as you see A.J. Green and Kerry Williams continued it well after the 8-yard game.
Jermaine Gresham has had injuries. Their Pro Bowl tight end. That time, the Bengals jumped into four wide receivers, threw a little bubble screen to Hawkins. Look for young Andrew Hawkins to make some plays creatively tonight for the Bengals. He's a guy they like to use creatively.
Only 5'7" out of Toledo. Dalton gets some time. Good shot over the middle. There's Green to the 42-yard line at a first down gain of 19.
Boy, this is nice play action. You're going to see the fullback come through the line of scrimmage, and they're going to throw a post right in behind that linebacker. Excellent execution, timing, and location. And A.J. Green on a sharp bend in snatches it in his hands. Good-looking play.
That was a tight window. A little space there. That's what I love about these kids. They're confident. Duo of sophomores now. Green Ellis running left. Ray Lewis over there with the tackle. It's past the 45-yard line. Year 17. 37 years old, looking better than ever, more confident than ever. He continues to defy the age and the years played.
He's light, Mike. He's 235 pounds. He said he rode his bike 40 miles a day. I have never seen Ray Lewis this light.
He's pressing up the middle, picked up. Dalton shot downfield towards Green. He just overthrew him. Darius Webb back there with coverage. John, so why did Ray turn into the Tour de Florida and bike 40 miles a day every day down in the sunshine?
Well, the game has changed. He said, hey, I don't have to take on fullbacks in the hole like I used to. It's a wide open passing game. I've got to change with the times, be able to cover backs, play in space. Give him credit. He lost 25 pounds drinking some vegetable drink and riding a bike every day. He loves it, man.
Watch the play clock. Movement. Was it caused by Pernell McPhee charging off the end?
It's got to be offsides against the Ravens.
Neutral zone infraction. Number 90 on the defense. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
You know, McPhee's the guy they worried about. He's off early against Jermaine Gresham. And once he gets into that neutral zone, that offensive player is entitled to protect himself and start his set. Good work by Gresham. Third and short.
These are the big conversions in the game. 10-0. Crowd lathered. Tough defense. Third and two. Green Ellis up the middle. Then Jarvis Green Ellis to the 37-yard line. The first down. Gain of 13.
Oh, that's that duo scheme they call it in Cincinnati. They get two double teams at the point of attack. Take a look at it. And Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis, is going to run right behind the push. That is good surge and good hard running by an NFL back.
You know who made a nice block there, too? That little guy, Hawkins, the wide receiver. He came down and got Pollard out of the way. That was a pretty impressive play. Dalton empties the backfield. Green Ellis split out as a receiver. Pressure coming. High toss. Green again. 17-yard line. Incomplete. Incomplete. Say it hit the ground. So no gain of 20.
Let's take a look at this. A.J. Green has got to catch this football. Ball's thrown a little high, but he's up. He snatches it. Let's see if he completes a football movement. We're going to call that incomplete. Although I would strongly disagree if I was a coach, but that's the rule now.
Man, there's two steps and going down there with the knee, but as he goes down to the ground, ball comes out, no challenge, Marvin Lewis. Second and 10, Dalton. Complete for the first down. That's another one of these young receivers, Armon Bins, first year out of Cincinnati, where he's marked with the spot. It's shy of the first down.
Well, just an outside breaking route. Andy Dalton shows a lot of confidence in his location right there. Armon Bins, a former practice squad wide receiver. He just emulated Larry Fitzgerald 1 week, Andre Johnson the next week. Jay Gruden says he's good enough to play in this league. Put him out there.
I don't think that spot was correct. It's third and one. Dalton's going to keep it. And makes it a moot point with a first down at the 25-yard line.
I want to go back to these young Bengal receivers. Armon Bins led the Big East in receiving when he was a member of the Cincinnati Bearcats. They have a lot of obscure receivers other than A.J. Green, Mike. Very important for guys like Hawkins, Ben, Tate. These young players need success early to take pressure off of A.J. Green and Jermaine Gresham. They're two young Pro Bowl skill guys.
Green Ellis galloping through the hole. Lewis with the tackle. Roy brings him down at the 20. Gain of 4. John, you called them obscure. I called them unproven. We know Tate played with the Patriots, mostly special teams. He had 24 catches all in the 2010 season. Hawkins, a little slot receiver last year. Bins, we just saw his first NFL catch. Mohamed Sanu out of Rutgers. And Marvin Jones, a rookie out of Cal, who they have been impressed with, taking the top off the defense, getting deep. So your brother's got to find somebody, not named Green or Gresham, to make plays in the passing game. In the hands of Bins, upended, ball down after he hit the ground. Looked to be a good call at the 16-yard line as the quarter comes to an end.
Going to be a physical game tonight. Excellent support by the Ravens secondary. Lardarius Webb.
Ground can't cause the fumble. It was correctly called by the officials. First quarter is over. Each team had the ball twice. The Ravens scored both times. The Bengals driving 10-0 after one in Baltimore.
What comes down to Monday night?
Great start to the 2012 season for the Ravens. Two drives, two scores. Mike Tirico, John Gruden, Lisa Salters on the sideline. Perfect 72-degree night here in Baltimore. I'm impressed with the Bengals back up at their own 8. Place going nuts. Very solid drive here. They've moved it, converting a couple of third and shorts. They begin the second with 3rd and 2. And Dalton with a heavy formation over the top for Gresham, incomplete. And it'll be 4th down.
We got to be really careful putting the ball in the middle of the field with Ray Lewis patrolling in center field. Watch number 20, left side of your screen. Close on Gresham. A little tight.
Ray not fooled a bit by the heavy formation, the play action to Green Ellis. You saw him. Well, that bicycle work. He backpedaled quick, didn't he?
Yes, he did.
Mike Nugent. Out of the hole to Kevin Huber, the snap of Clark Harris. That trio returns. 34-yard field goal. Starting at their own 8 after a special teams mistake. It's a pretty good drive for the Bengals to get points on the board for the first time in 2012. Bengals opened the season on Monday Night Football. They did in Cincinnati in 2007. Ravens turned it over 6 times. Bengals won the game 27-20. Here, 4 drives and 3 scores, and John Harbaugh has seen his team moving very well. And, John, this is a pressure time for Marvin Lewis's defense. They've got to come out and respond here at the start of the second quarter.
You're right. They have not handled the no huddle very well at all. That long drive by the Bengals should have given defensive coordinator Mike Zimmer some time to get his troops organized. They should be acclimated to the tempo a little bit. I look for Cincinnati defensively to step it up.
Nugent with the kick. Deontay Thompson, 6 yards deep. The rookie out of Florida brings it out. And he won't get up to the 20-yard line. Cedric Pierman, Dan Scuda on the tackle. This was it last year. They were so close. Lee Evans almost had Sterling Moore made a play to help knock it away. And Billy Cundiff's missed field goal. He missed it. And the Ravens missed their chance to go to the Super Bowl and represent the AFC. A stinging, stunning 23-20 loss. The night when Joe Flacco played very well, his stats better than Brady's. They went to New England and responded. They just couldn't come up with the play in the moment. Ray Rice on the run, up the middle, big run, Rice. The 34-yard line. It's a good gain of 16 to start the drive. Taylor Mays tackle.
Boy, just the reverse pivot right off the left side. Take a look at the surge. A little trap play. Well blocked by right guard Marshall Yanda. Ravens look great on offense.
Ramon Harrowood out there leading. He started at left guard, surprising some folks here tonight. Flacco from the gun comes on his center, and Rice gains a yard. I want to come back to that AFC Championship game loss. We talked on the bus this week with Rice and Flacco and Reed and Lewis, all the leaders of this team, about a hangover. I didn't sense one, did you?
No, I mean, they had just as tough a defeat 2 years ago in Pittsburgh. They had a 14-point lead against the Pittsburgh Steelers. They lost that game ugly in the second half. They came back. This is a very mentally tough football team.
Flacco, second and 9. Jacoby Jones behind the secondary. Out down to the 40 and a first down gain of 25.
That's an amazing throw.
Wow.
It's covered to Jones, releases off of Newman down into the void between the corner and the safety. That's just a tremendous throw and great concentration. Look at the throw. Wow. Tough to stop that.
With new addition to this team, Jones, Rice up the middle again. The gain of 6 to the 34-yard line. So, John, let's think about the pieces they have. They've got the two tight ends. Are they Gronkowski and Hernandez from New England? No. But they're very impactful. Torrey Smith, the game breaker. Bolden, the veteran, always gets 50 catches. And Jacoby Jones, Ray Rice. They've got something everywhere. What options they have in this offense this year?
Right now, they've forced Cincinnati into a state of regularity, and Flacco's just picking them apart.
Second and 4, Flacco flinging for Bolden. Went to the ground and held on. Touchdown, Bolden.
Joe Flacco looks as good as I've ever seen him look. He's making all kind of throws, all kind of audibles. And the Ravens are on fire as an offensive football team. He sees the single safety. He's going to audible. Everybody gets it. He's going to look off the free safety with a little pump, and he throws the ball right down the middle. That's Pro Bowl stuff by Flacco. Let's see if Anquan Bolden held on.
A little bit of the ball touching the ground there. Every score gets automatically reviewed, as you know. Going back to last year, and now they'll take a longer look. See the nose of the ball just hitting the ground there as Bolden's arm comes off.
That looks incomplete to me.
The previous play is under review.
So Richard Nix, the referee, is going to go take a peek under the hood. See if Bolden held on or not.
ESPN's Monday Night Football is brought to you by GMC. Enter the Never Say Never Sweepstakes for a chance to win a 2013 GMC vehicle at gmc.com/NFL. Miller Lite, because when friends come together, it's not just a good time, it's Miller time. And ESPNShop.com, where you can get all of your official NFL sideline gear.
Tonight from Baltimore, our aerial coverage is brought to you by DirecTV. Watching the replay, and here is Richard Nix, the call, touchdown or no for the Ravens.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands.
Rule the touchdown, 16-3. Ravens on top. Let's take another look at this. Let's watch the ball as it slides there. Does he maintain control and comes across the ground? As we get ready for the extra point, we have Jerry Austin, refereeing two Super Bowls, up here in the booth with us. Jerry, your thoughts on that?
Well, my thoughts are that the receiver did not complete the process. Now, the referee said the call stands, meaning from his point of view, he did not have visual evidence to indicate that he could change the ruling. But I think it's very clear that the ball comes loose when he hits the ground, therefore not completing the process, making it an incomplete pass.
You heard Jerry and how he saw the play. Watch it again as Bolden goes to the ground. And it is ruled by the referee, looking under the hood on the field. As it stands, not confirmed, as Jared see enough to overturn it there, and it becomes 17-3, the Ravens on top.
So you know what, Mike, I just have to say, we can sit here and dispute this call all night. Joe Flacco is playing great football. Five plays, 82 yards. He's doing it all himself. I don't see him getting much help from the sidelines. He's recognizing the fronts. He's recognizing the coverages. He just looked off the free safety and made a magnificent throw down the seam to Bolden. Jacoby Jones has had a great debut here. We've already seen Torrey Smith get deep. Now Anquan Bolden. Plenty of Ray Rice. You defend this offense.
That's the way they drew it up in the offseason. The blueprint, sit the green on the field very successfully to start. Brandon Tate, poor decision, last kickoff. This time the stop sign's a little more pronounced from Cedric Pierman. And no return. Joe Flacco. Well, you hear it a lot the last 2 weeks. Four more years, everybody's chance at the conventions, right? Well, they'd like to have four more years like this from Flacco. 44 wins his first four seasons. And a quarterback starting a playoff game each of those first four. Only Flacco and Otto Graham, the Browns legend of six decades ago. Playoffs have more teams getting in, but it doesn't diminish from what Flacco's come in and done on a team that's personality was set, dominant defense. But the offense is starting to wrestle some of that away. Dalton and the Bengals. A.J. Green on a gain of five in front of Ed Reed.
Cincinnati doing a nice job moving A.J. Green around. Here in his second year as a Bengal, he knows this offense better. That time they put him in motion, jetted out of his stance, catches a quick out. Good looking play.
Jarvis Green Ellis seemed to run. Elodie Nata kept him from spinning and getting the first down, along with Courtney Upshaw, the second round pick for the Ravens.
Creative play that time. They brought Andrew Hawkins in motion. They fake a jet sweep to Hawkins. You're going to see it. Watch it. Coming underneath. They fake the jet sweep and they hand the ball to Green Ellis. A lot of misdirection from this Bengal offense.
They converted a couple of third and shorts on the last drive. And third and one with a fullback lead. Green Ellis has that and more. Jarvis Green Ellis to the 41-yard line.
That's pretty impressive. We talked about the inexperienced left guard, Clint Bowling, the new center, Jeff Fain. They just gash the Baltimore Ravens. Look at number 65, Bowling, 62, Fain, running behind the lead block. That's impressive. Good response by these young Bengals that are pressed into service. Jeff Fain, the former Buccaneer, Bowling at left guard, and the rookie Zeitler at right guard.
Not a great third and one team last year, but so far they've converted a couple of third and ones and a third and two in this first half. Dalton quick out of his hands, Andrew Hawkins. Jitterbug move back to the inside to 47. You might remember his brother, Artrell Hawkins, who's a Cincinnati Bengal as well.
Ravens love to bring pressure off the edge. You're going to see Lardarius Webb come screaming off the corner. Andy Dalton sees it. He expects it, throws the ball hot to the outside. Off goes Hawkins. Andy Dalton is a sharp quarterback. He sees a lot.
Reno's run up the middle. A couple yards shy for the first down. So we're sitting with Marvin Lewis last night. We're talking about Andy Dalton. And you know, he asked the typical question, like, did you expect? Did you expect how good it would be with this young kid? And he took us back to Good Friday before the draft. And he said, we're down at TCU and we're with Andy Dalton. Like, who else is talking to you? Because when they met him, they fell in love with him.
He was a nervous wreck on draft day, just hoping that Andy Dalton would fall to him at the top of the second round. Everything worked out for the Bengals.
Throw, third and short. First look was covered. Can't scramble for it. Nata helps collapse the pocket and bring down Dalton for a sack in fourth down.
It's unfortunate. Andy Dalton saw the blitz. Saw one-on-one coverage, audible to Armon Benz, and Kerry Williams jumped it. You're going to see the blitz coming. Andy Dalton's going to change it. You're going to see it on the left side of your screen, the one-on-one coverage, and Kerry Williams jumped it. There's nowhere for Dalton to go.
Kevin Huber punting for the Bengals for the second time tonight. 39 yards on the punt. Lardarius Webb will return a four to the 24-yard line. Field goal, touchdown, touchdown. The Ravens offense is 3 for 3. Back on the field after this. M&T Bank Stadium, 71,000 here, just off the Inner Harbor in Baltimore. Only the Patriots have been better at home the last decade than the Ravens. The Ravens have picked up where they left off. Three drives, three scores. And now Bernard Pierce, the rookie out of Temple, is in, replacing Ray Rice. And that's his first NFL regular season carry for a gain of 3 yards. Those first three drives have been impressive for the Ravens. Started their own 21, their own 37, their own 18. And they have 17 points to show. Flacco back up top to the middle, and Ed Dixon incomplete, and a flag thrown for a hit on a defenseless receiver by Taylor Mays.
That's just a foolish play by Taylor Mays. Inexcusable, really. Right off of the play action pass, they throw the seam to the tight end, and he's a defenseless receiver, and Marvin Lewis can't like that at all.
Personal foul, number 26. On the defense, hit to the head, 15 yards, first down.
In addition to that, he launched as well. Defenseless, hit to the head, launch in many different categories. And the DBs know they have adjusted their strike zone to the places they need to be where you're not going to get a penalty.
Hurts your football team, and it's going to hurt his wallet too, I have a feeling.
Flacco again up top. Into Bengal territory with Bolden to the 45. It's 13. First down yards with an Nate Clemens tackle.
Anquan Bolden looks great. Had a bad knee when he went to camp last year. This time he's going to drive off the ball. Burst turn, ball's thrown perfectly. Look at him snatch the football. Strong hands, compact. Beautiful work by a veteran receiver. He's closing in on 10,000 yards in his career.
Fake to Pierce, screen to Leach, the fullback. They chant Leach. Javonte pounds forward, but a penalty marker down. We're at the halfway point of the second quarter.
Beautifully designed power screen pass back to Vontae Leach.
Block in the back, number 82 on the offense. 10 yards from the spot of the foul, repeat, first down.
Good news is my receiver's blocking. Bad news, in the wrong place. Leon Hall's spin didn't help him. Wasn't exactly one of the heaviest blocks in the back of all time, but
oh, it wasn't.
Takes it back to first and 17. It's a spot foul. And Flacco goes back to Ray Rice, who returns to the game. You know, John, I'm thinking about the Ravens here. The last couple of years, you had good backs backing up Ray Rice. Ricky Williams last year, Willis McGahee before that. It's the one thing about this team, because they don't want to give Ray Rice all the carries. They want to get him a chance to catch some rest.
Oh, you're exactly right. Ricky Williams had 440 yards last year, picked up blitzes, did some things in a passing game. Be interested to see if Bernard Pierce, their rookie, can fill the bill.
Pressure off the corner, not getting there. The pass is deflected by Ray Maaluga. An incomplete. Nate Clemens' corner blitz started the clock running quick.
Well, they like to use these double A-gap blitzes in Cincinnati. Two linebackers in these A-gaps. And then they bring perimeter pressure off the side. That's a bad blitz by the Bengals. Number 91, Robert Gathers, was blitzing the same gap that Nate Clemens had. That's why Clemens couldn't get there.
Just the third incompletion for Flacco. Third and long, Baltimore. Bengals desperate for a stop, bring pressure again and get to Flacco. This time the other corner, Pac-Man, formerly known as Adam Jones, brought the start of the heat, and he and Thomas Howard combined for the takedown.
One thing I know about the Bengals, they will not quit. Adam Jones comes right off this boundary corner, and Joe Flacco never saw him. Zone coverage with perimeter blitzes. Mike Zimmer going deep into his playbook with two good ones back-to-back.
So for the first time, the Ravens are forced to punt. Very good punter, and Sam Cook to send it away. Scoot almost got in there for a block. Brandon Tate from the 14 returns it to the 18-yard line. They finally keep Flacco off the scoreboard. Back-to-back blitzes, including Adam Jones. Don't fit in amidst the sea of purple here at M&T Bank Stadium. Fourth drive for the Bengals. All have started inside their own 21. Andy Dalton, A.J. Green tried the back shoulder. But a good job defensively by Bernard Pollard to knock it away. Where's Green been tonight, John?
Well, Jay Gruden's trying to move him around as many ways as they can. Early in the game, they played him at flanker. On the strong side, you see him at the bottom of the screen to the tight end side. Keep watching the game. They get to a slot formation. They're trying to get the ball to A.J. Green. Then later in the ball game, they go to an empty backfield. They've got him on a slot into the short side of the field. That time they just went to him, and Bernard Pollard broke it up.
Good to Andrew Hawkins. Good job by Hawkins. Outside the numbers, and Hawkins out of bounds to 46 in 27 for the 5'7" man out of Toledo.
Man, is he quick. Here comes the Ravens with an inside blitz. Andy Dalton sees it, gets the ball to the edge on a quick screen. Good block by Armon Benz. Here comes help. And Hawkins, he's got some short area quickness. Look at Andrew Whitworth getting downfield, blocking Ed Reed.
Hawkins played in the Canadian Football League on the champion Montreal team in 09 and 10. Most of his work after he catches a short one from Dalton. Goes down, here's Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis out of the backfield. Wrapped up by Ray Lewis at midfield. Wouldn't let him get away. The future Hall of Famer.
That's why you lose that weight. Ray Lewis wants to be able to play in space. That time they have four receivers running vertical. You're going to see Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis come on a little check down. If Ray Lewis doesn't make this open field tackle, it's a gain of 12 to 15. Is that good stuff or what, Mike?
Every linebacker to Florida on a bike 40 miles a day, every day next year. Six first half tackles. On the 21, Cincinnati plays running the first half. Green Ellis keeps going to the first down at the 43-yard line. You know, John, Cincinnati's done pretty well against Baltimore. And you asked Ray Lewis on the bus on Saturday, why? He said very simple. It's Marvin Lewis. Marvin was here with the original Ravens as a defensive coach. And Ray Lewis said, Marvin knows what we do and what we say and how we do. Ray's made a few people head coaches over his time. The 43 pressure off the corner by Webb. Able to get it out to Brandon Tate. And it will gain of about 3 yards.
You know, last year, Ladarius Webb, Ed Reed, Bernard Pollard, they came off the edge. I call them stingers. Strong safety blitzes. This is a nickel stinger. And Andy Dalton has seen all three of them tonight. Going to come right off this left side. Andy Dalton sees it. He throws the ball quickly to the outside. Bengals' young quarterback is sharp.
Ryan Leonard out of Rutgers, Ray Rice's backfield teammate in Piscataway is in the backfield. Second and seven, Dalton with a rocket to the middle, caught by Hawkins. Just shy of the first down. I want to come back to Hawkins for a second. Remember the 49ers game against Dallas last year? The Cowboys won out there and Jesse Holly made the big play?
Yep.
Bengals going to run to the line of scrimmage, try to keep the Ravens from subbing, so we'll stay here on third and one. And Dalton going to try to find space, and I don't know if he got there. They'll umpire and spot, and Courtney Upshaw will punch at Gresham. I'm going to stop it here for the measurement at 250, see if it's fourth down or not. So anyway, so Jesse Holly made the big play in overtime and a big punt return. Well, he won Michael Irvin's reality show to get a spot in a tryout in Cowboys camp. You know who came in second in that show?
No idea.
Andrew Hawkins.
I'll be darned.
And then he went to the CFL, and he played well up there and worked his way to an NFL camp. So he went from reality show to CFL, got cut after 3 days with St. Louis. Now here he is with the home with the Bengals. And his team needs a foot on fourth down.
Now this is why you drafted Kevin Zeitler out of Wisconsin in the first round. At Wisconsin, running the ball is a must-win situation. You got a tough, smart, consistent run blocking right guard. You got the biggest offensive line in football. You went out and got Ben Jarvis, Green Ellis. You're down by 14. Critical play here for the Bengal offense. Big Dennis Rowland, number 74, is checked in as an eligible tight end.
Green Ellis got him. First down. Just shy of the 30-yard line.
That's Zeitler at right guard. I loved everything about Zeitler when they handed the ball off at Wisconsin. Just come off the ball, good pad level, and bang it across that yellow line for the first down. Good call by Marvin Lewis. Well blocked.
Zeitler, the first round pick, 27th overall. Clint Bowling, fourth round pick of last year. Think they miss Zeitler at Wisconsin?
Yeah, ask Monty Ball. It wasn't the same Badger team I remember.
Offensive line coach got fired after 2 weeks. 2 minute warning here in Baltimore. Bengals down 14, but driving. It's been a Raven offense dominated first half.
Know your name. What's your name? Turn around. Let me see your name. Turn around. Let me see your name. Turn around. I don't know you, bro.
Vic Foster, some of the big names in the NFL. We'll hear on the Toyota Halftime Show some of the soundtracks of yesterday in the NFL. The great Peyton Manning Show. We saw a preview of Game 2 of the Monday Night Doubleheader, the Chargers and the Raiders, and Chris Morton, Adam Schefter with the news and notes. Susie Colbert joins them for the Toyota Halftime Show coming up in a bit. All challenges happen upstairs inside the two-minute warning. Bengals full complement of timeouts, first and 10.
Ravens are confused after that shift.
Dalton with an empty backfield, sends five in the pattern, and chooses underneath with A.J. Green to the 15-yard line as Albert McClellan made the tackle. First down.
Oh, I like that. Nice shift by the Bengals. They get A.J. Green one-on-one against the linebacker. And this is where the Ravens are at their best defensively, the top red zone defense in football. And I think they are good down here because they mix their coverages as well as anyone in the league.
Well, with Green Ellis, good gallop inside for 3 yards. Lewis the tackle. Buck still running, neither team stops. There it is, John. 38% of the red zone possessions against the Ravens turned into touchdowns. So two out of about every five. That was the best in the league. And they've been up in the top five each of the last 8 years. Any defensive stat you put up, they're in the top five since Ray.
Hard to run down here against the Ravens. You see Nata, Cody.
Green Ellis goes up to the top of the screen. Dalton, nothing open. Good job to get its aggression. Wrapped up by Bernard Pollard. Inbounds. Yard shy of the first down. Clock turning at 38 seconds. Might want to take a timeout here. And they do. 35 seconds left. Cincinnati and Marvin Lewis takes one. Dalton hit his last six. Got another third and short coming up to 35 and a half. Have to keep drives going. Facing third and one on this, the 12th play of the drive. Raven timeout coming. John Harbaugh ran down, saw how they were lined up, and burns one of his two timeouts. Here with 35 seconds to go. Keep the same play, to make a change. It's been a very good drive for Cincinnati, taking them down from their own 19-yard line, down 17-3. Andrew Hawkins, 27-yard pass, catch and run on a second down. Moving near midfield, though, with Brandon Tate for the grab, pushed out of bounds. Then underneath, working back with the 5-7 Hawkins. And Jarvis Green-Ellis had a good 7-yard run. John, they've handled the blitz, mixed in the run, have effectively worked it down, picked up one third and one, and now they face another one.
We talked about this Raven red zone defense. If you want to beat Baltimore and end this 10-game home winning streak, you're going to have to score touchdowns in the red zones. Critical the Bengals convert this short yardage.
Green Ellis is the back. A.J. Green's top of the screen, third and a yard. Looking to throw. Green was covered. Dalton rolling out. Goes to the back for Gresham. Broken up by Ed Reed. Fourth down. Field goal attempt. They're going for it. Going to go for it here. Interesting.
Well, it's a play-action pass, and nobody really open. Andy Dalton might have got away with one right there. Fourth and one, you must watch the hard count right here. If you're the Ravens, Andy Dalton might be trying to draw the Ravens offside.
He's saying they got 12 on the huddle, breaking the huddle. John Harbaugh tried to run down and get a timeout called. Confusion by the Raven personnel defensively, and the timeout has been given to the Ravens. They've adjusted the rule this year to talk about when 12 players are out there, the delay of game, too many men on the field, I should say, is called. But that's only when the snap is imminent. So watch as you start counting. Ravens subbing in, subbing out. Am I in? You out? How many we got? 12? We got 13? What do we have? We had two come in and one go out.
That's what happens when you think the other team's going to kick a field goal. You send a certain group out there to block that kick. All of a sudden, here comes the Bengals with the offensive personnel group.
Jerry Austin up here in the booth believes that should have been a flag, even though a snap was not imminent at that point. Because the Bengals were coming to the line at that point after huddling. No flag, timeout used by the Ravens. Will the Bengals run a play, fourth and one? They will. They'll run it with Ben Jarvis Green-Ellis. Wow. Twist to the end zone. Did he get in? Yes. Touchdown, Cincinnati.
What a gutty call by Marvin Lewis.
Well, now, wait, John. The far side official has signaled touchdown. The near side official says down. And now they've stopped the clock. The elbow was down as the ball was being reached forward by Green-Ellis. The official on the near side.
The ruling on the field is a touchdown.
Mm-hmm. And the official on the near side came running in and spotting it short of the goal line. The far side said touchdown.
Well, we're going to find out here shortly. They're going to review all scoring plays. Am I right, Mike?
Yes, and that's almost, you're almost better off, John. You know, if I was an official, here's what I'd do. I'd say, if it's close, yeah, touchdown. Go review it. We'll get it right.
What a run by Ben Jarvis Green-Ellis.
Every scoring play does get looked at upstairs in the last 2 minutes. And they buzz down and say if it should be looked at closer. And nobody buzzed down, so no need to look any further. Nugent's extra point is good. And it is 17-10. This one getting good as week one wraps up. And then there's next week. I don't know if you saw Peyton Manning last night. The sheriff was he was back holding law and order once again. What a job he did against Pittsburgh. And his really dramatic and exciting to watch return for everyone but Steeler fans.
Yeah, it really was. I couldn't go to sleep. I stayed up all night. I was so excited to see Manning play again and to see him play that well with a new cast of characters out in Denver. I thought it was great. I was also really impressed, as were you, with Matt Ryan and this Atlanta Falcon team. You got to see some of these highlights.
Yeah, Peyton was as sharp as ever, and the arm strength was such a question. As the game got rolling, seemed like he was even more in gear. Demaryius Thomas took that one home.
A lot of these are just Peyton Manning audibling. He audibled to both of those touchdown passes, if you ask me. But how about Matt Ryan and Dirk Cutter, the new offensive coordinator, meet Julio Jones? Tony Gonzalez, I forgot Roddy White was even a Falcon. They are loaded in Atlanta. That place will be rocking next week. But what a drive by the Bengals. Marvin Lewis goes for it on fourth and one, and Ben Jarvis does exactly what he did for the New England Patriots, where he had 24 rushing touchdowns the last two seasons. If that doesn't fire you up, if you're a Bengal going into the locker room at halftime, there's something wrong with you.
And they get the ball to start the second half. Very impressive run there on fourth and one by Green-Ellis. Nugent with the kick. Deontay Thompson bringing it out. Thompson keeping this return alive. Brought down to 24 with 12 seconds. Now 11. And we have a penalty flag down. After they sort this out, we're going to go back to the touchdown, give you an explanation.
Holding, number 37 on the return team. 10 yards from the spot of the foul, first down.
And again, we bring in Jerry Austin. Let's go back and look at the replay, Jerry, and talk about Green-Ellis and the wrist and why it's important on this play.
This year, the wrist is part of the hand. So he's not down until something other than the hand or wrist. And see, by the time his elbow touches, the ball has broken the plane. It's a touchdown.
That's a great upgrade for the wrist this year, guys, huh? The wrist is, it has much more meaning.
You're killing me.
That's why we have Jerry. You know, it's great to have a guy who's been on the field in the biggest game, referee in the Super Bowl, to keep you in order, Gruden.
Yes, it is.
It's so much easier for me. Good half. Bengals get the ball to start the third. 17-10 Baltimore. Here is Susie Culver with the Toyota halftime show. Susie. Stones get us ready. return here for the second half in Baltimore. Mike Tirico, John Gruden. Lisa Salter's on the sideline. 17-10 Ravens. What a start for Baltimore. There's no huddle offense with Joe Flacco, John. Three drives, three scores, and Flacco dialed in right at the start.
No question, and he did it a lot of different ways with his arm and with his ability to audible to running plays. But the first play of the game, play action pass, he sees the one-on-one coverage in Torrey Smith for a long game. And then he pumps the free safety, throws a beautiful pass to Bolden for a touchdown. He audible to that play. Here's a trap play he audibles to. He sees a split safety defense, and off goes Ray Rice. He's been able to decipher what the Bengals are doing. Put the team in optimum plays. It's really paid off. Flacco's done a great job.
It's not Mike Zimmer's first day on that sideline over there. He's been a coordinator for about a decade and a half, and they made nice adjustments as the quarter went on.
Oh, yeah, they did. Mike Zimmer says, I'll go to my double A package. And he brings Nate Clemens off a single slot down at the bottom of the screen. Flacco throws the ball into a zone coverage, almost intercepted. Then on a next down on third down, they bring two defenders off the short side. Rotation comes to the side of the blitz, and Pac-Man Jones gets an uncontested sack. So Mike Zimmer says, okay, I got some irregulars for you too, Ravens. Excellent adjustment by Zimmer late in that half. It'll be interesting to see if the Bengals can play 30 minutes of good, solid defense, because offensively, they're moving the ball against this Raven defense.
They certainly have kept drives alive, converting third and shorts, making the power plays, the physical plays that you need to make in this division against Baltimore, against Pittsburgh. Andy Dalton was telling us last night, you know, we were 0-4 against those guys, so we know that we need to figure out ways to win, and that was a physical, tough drive that took them down the field 81 yards to essentially end the half with a touchdown, and Cincinnati will get the ball to start third.
Got to get a play out of the kicking game. So far, Tate's been quiet.
Bouncing kick from Justin Tucker. Tate can't field it. Touchback. And before the Bengals take over at the 20-yard line, let's send it down to Lisa Salter.
Hey, Mike. Well, I was talking to John Harbaugh, and he says he's actually pleased with the way his defense held up in that first half. Remember, the Ravens are playing without the reigning defensive player of the year in Terrell Suggs. He's over here on the Ravens sidelines in shorts and a T-shirt. But Harbaugh said that the young guys really did step up, and he's really pleased with the way they're playing. As for Marvin Lewis and his defense, he said, you know what, we've just got to focus on what we're doing. They executed well in that first half. He said, we did not on defense. We had the opportunity to make some plays, and we just didn't. He said, but eventually, we're going to have to stop them on defense if we're going to win this ball game. Mike.
All right, Lisa, thank you. The offense begins the third. Pressure picked up right away. Dalton up top, fighting for the ball and catching it one more time. The 34-yard line. A.J. Green has such strong hands. Gain of 14.
Watch this blitz pickup right here. Just listen to this at home. I'll tell you what. Number 36, the fullback, Chris Presley, just stuffed an A-gap blitz on the first play of the second half. That's how it's done.
You got Jameel McClain and gave Dalton the time to complete it to Green. But Jarvis Green-Ellis, a decent first half. He runs to the 42-yard line. Green-Ellis, a 12 carries, 62 yards in that first half. Here are all the numbers from the first. Dominated by the Ravens with a good offense early. Cincinnati, the time possession, sometimes misleading, was really important because they kept it away from Flacco on that hot offense when they were rolling.
No question. And if you look out on the Raven field right now, number 22, Jimmy Smith, last year's first rounder, has just checked in at left corner. He's a guy I know Cincinnati like to go after.
Ellis running to the left, met in the hole by Donnell Ellerby, but the spot's going to give Ellis the first down at the Cincinnati 45.
The Ravens have three very good young corners. We talked about Kerry Williams, Lardarius Webb. Jimmy Smith, number 22, is an interesting defender. He's big. He's got bump and run fundamentals from his days at Colorado. He's had a hard time finding the ball, and I do know that Cincinnati would like to get after him at some point in this game.
He's bailing in coverage. Dalton's looking it that way. A.J. Green's right in front of him on cue to the 38-yard line. First down, gain of 17.
Yeah, A.J. Green had his way with Colorado a couple years ago, and he says, give me the ball. Little stutter go move. Watch it. A.J.'s going to stutter, take off, and Jimmy Smith is running out of there, and A.J. just settles now. Good adjustment by Green and A.J. Dalton.
Green went off, as you saw, the end of that play, coming up big gingerly, limped off to the sideline. He missed one of the two games with the Ravens last year, and in the other game, he only had two catches. Green Ellis to the left. For a couple of yards, A.J. Green doing some deep bends over on the sidelines, and now comes in. Number four pick in the draft, 6'4", 207 pounds, John, last year. First rookie wide receiver elected to the Pro Bowl. It wasn't those like late add-ons because 38 guys didn't go. First one since Anquan Boldin went as a rookie in 03.
I like about him is his desire, his dedication, and his work ethic are probably his greatest strengths. There's no diva in A.J. Green.
Brian Leonard's the back, swing out to Andrew Hawkins, got a downfield block, and got a first down. Hawkins out of bounds right around the 25-yard line.
He is quick. The Ravens are playing a lot of zone coverage. They're crowding the box, and Andy Dalton is hurting them with quick screens on the perimeter to Hawkins. And what Marvin Lewis tell us yesterday, Mike, he said, we have receivers that will block. That time it's A.J. Green, Armand Benz. When you throw a bubble screen to a receiver and he makes yards, it's because you have wideouts blocking the perimeter. Good work.
Ravens playing the nickel, playing five DBs. Here's Leonard up the middle. He gets it to the 22-yard line. A pretty good backfield back at Rutgers. Brian Leonard and Ray Rice, they were together 2005, 2006. Leonard's in his sixth year in the league now. He's traded here from St. Louis. It serves as one of the backups. Bernard Scott is the player the Bengals are relying on to be the backup running back. Hand injury. He's been out most of the preseason. I expect to see him hopefully next week, if not the week after. Pressure off the edge from Ed Reed. Dalton the other way. Andrew Hawkins. There's no safety behind Williams, who has to push him out of bounds. The 8-yard line. Andy Dalton wants to get to the huddle and keep going quick.
Well, Jay Gruden and Andy Dalton have great tempo going. Baltimore looks tired. It's another quick screen. Watch number 19, Brandon Tate. Excellent job against Lardarius Webb on the edge. And I just feel like the Ravens are running out of gas here on defense. Hands are on their hips. Not enough penetration and get off that you're accustomed to seeing from this Raven defense so far early in this third quarter.
Inside the 10, the Bengals have run it well. Inside with Green Ellis. Bernard Pollard knows that. Comes across for the stop after a gain of a yard to the 7.
Bernard Pollard hasn't run out of gas. He's made a lot of plays tonight. That time another strong safety blitz. And he has the speed to just run plays down. They love these strong safety blitzes. And Bernard Pollard has really flourished here as a Baltimore Raven.
Second and goal, Dalton. Incomplete. Green crossing with third down coming up. Lardarius Webb again on the coverage. Gets set for third down. Jay Gruden works off that play sheet. Marvin Lewis's team has been good in the red zone here, especially in that second quarter. Keeping drives alive. This one's third and goal against Ray Lewis and the Raven D in this 71,000 crowd in Baltimore.
I expect another zone defense. Three-man rush.
Green, lone receiver, bottom of the screen. Gresham, the tight end, to the near side. Dalton keeping, running, seeking the goal line. Takes a big hit, a yard short. Going to be fourth down.
That's a very good call against a three-man rush, which you see a lot of. And Andy Dalton just a little bit short. You're going to see Eller be number 50, drop out of there. They're fanning the field with zone defenders, and Andy Dalton does a nice job. Maybe just a little too far out, Mike.
Mm-hmm. For that play, and Webb and Pollard come off their men. They come over, that face of disappointment from Dalton was when he saw Mike Nugent running on the field. They wanted to go for another fourth and one. Instead, it's Nugent from 19 yards. That's back-to-back drives with scores for the Bengals. It's 17-3. 10 in a row for Cincinnati. 11 plays and 79 yards on the drive to tighten the game.
Military and their families have relied on Navy Federal Credit Union for their banking and loan needs. Visit us at NavyFederal.org and see what we can do for you. Experience truly great engineering today at your authorized dealer.
Great naval background and feel to this city of Baltimore, Maryland as well. You look at the Inner Harbor, not too far from M&T Bank Stadium. She's virtually next door to Oriole Park at Camden Yards. Some good sports times down here this summer. Four-point game now, 17-13. Deontay Thompson back deep to receive. Rookie from Florida, what a play by Cedric Pierman. The guy who's made the good choices in trying to say, don't run it out of the end zone, Tate. That time said, I'll take you down to 10 in coverage. Been a long time since we've seen Joe Flacco and his offense run a play. They'll be on the field when you come back. Since three drives, three scores, pick up the first down on that next drive, but some blitz pressure, able to force him to punt. This is the first play that Flacco and the Ravens have run, other than a kneel down, in 51 minutes. And it's stopped by a flag.
False start, number 82 on the offense. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
John, it was 10 after 8 local time when the Ravens had that drive end. And then Dalton goes down the field, gets the touchdown, the run by Green Ellis. They come out and kneel for one play. So it's been about 12 minutes on the clock and 50 minutes on your watch since the Ravens' offense has been in drive mode.
Been that long for the Bengals' defense as well. And it's critical as Cincinnati takes advantage of this negative field position and gets off here while they have the Ravens behind in the down and distance.
First and 15, Flacco out of his own end zone. Good throw, Dennis Pitta. Got back up and got four more yards out to the 29. Gain of 23.
Cincinnati is a fast flow defense, and they have struggled a lot with bootleg play action passes. That time, everybody went with Ray Rice. Watch the linebackers. Nobody can get back to cover Pitta, and it's another well thrown ball by Flacco.
Quick throw, Pitta. Well read coming up. Out of the secondary by safety Reggie Nelson.
Speaking of safeties, you look out there in that Bengal defense. Number 45 has just checked in. Jeremy Miles, third-year safety out of Massachusetts. He's replacing Taylor Mays, who's had his struggles tonight.
Mays was brought in. They replaced Chris Crocker. Didn't bring him back as a starting safety. Flacco's pass broken up by Leon Hall, but a flag as he was draped over the body of Anquan Boldin.
Well, that's a bang-bang play on a slant.
Pass interference. Number 29 on the defense. Automatic first down.
Second accepted penalty against Cincinnati here tonight.
Boy, I don't see that at all.
Deep drop, Flacco. Again looking for Pitta. That time the coverage, Reggie Nelson all over him. Broke it up. Incomplete.
Blitz was on by the Bengals. Flacco standing strong in the pocket. Makes another great throw to the tight end. That time Reggie Nelson timed it perfectly. I just didn't see much difference in this play that Nelson made and the one that Leon Hall was just flagged for. But great break, great play by Nelson.
Ray Rice down at the bottom of the screen. Out of the empty backfield, right to him quickly. Downfield blocking, Michael Orr sends Rice down the sideline. First down in the Bengals territory at the 44.
Well, they love to throw the quick screen to Ray Rice in these no-back sets. That time Cincinnati didn't blitz. They bluffed out of the blitz, and watch number 82, Torrey Smith, number 74, Michael Orr, clean up Bengals on the perimeter. When you can throw a quick screen out there and gain this many yards, you're getting some good down the field blocking.
Orr back to left tackle where it was two seasons ago. Lowers the shoulder to the 31-yard line. Gain of 13.
Look, Joe Flacco with just a straight draw play right behind Vontae Leach. Bengals are dropping into pass coverage, and Ray Rice has the ball. That's a bad combination. But watch Vontae Leach on this lead draw go get Ray Maluga. They're gashing the Bengals.
Rice out. Bernard Pierce, the rookie out of Temple, is back up in. Good reset. Dixon holding on for the first down. Ed Dixon to the 12-yard line.
Ed Dixon. He had over 50 catches last year. Got hurt early in the preseason against the Falcons, but watch him square this off, find the ball, and catch it away from his body. Ravens have a lot of playmakers, and Joe Flacco is on tonight, Mike.
Flacco 16 of 20 throwing tonight. Hands it to Pierce. Gets it to the 10-yard line. And John, we talked about the variety of weapons Flacco has to choose from. He's been using them all here tonight. Hitting Rice, Bolden, the first shot to Torrey Smith. And there you see how he's spread in terms of the positions that have caught balls.
I just like the way he's taking advantage of his opportunity to run the show tonight. He's been awesome.
Flacco hit by Pecco. Put it up for grabs. Incomplete. Oh, it was almost an interception. And a poor decision there. Leon Hall had his hands on it.
There's Domantas Pecco finally on a little trap pass. You're going to see the penetration right off the right side of the center. Pecco pushes Matt Turk right into the lap of Joe Flacco, and they're lucky that wasn't intercepted. Bengals have had a couple tip ball opportunities tonight on defense, haven't come up with it. No back set again for the Ravens.
On third and eight, Flacco lost it for his tight end. Going up to get it is Pinna. Brings it down. Touchdown, Baltimore.
That's just great quarterback play right there. And the blitz is on. Flacco knew his personnel. He knew he had the big man. Pinna screeching down the middle of the field. He put it up high where his big man could go get it. Here comes a blitz right up the middle. Flacco flips it up high. Takes advantage of Pinna's size, strength. Advantage against number 29, Leon Hall. Flacco's loving this, Mike.
He's playing great tonight. Justin Tucker adds the extra point. Dennis Pitt is 5 inches taller than Leon Hall. Gonna go up and get it. Walk down the field for a touchdown. Ends tonight with game two of the Monday Night Football doubleheader. Week one comes to a conclusion. Phillip Rivers and the Chargers in Oakland to take on Darren McFadden, Carson Palmer and the Raiders. Chris Berman and Trent Dilfer call it for you coming up as soon as we're done here on ESPN. And we welcome those of you who watched the epic U.S. Open men's tennis final. Congratulations, Andy Murray. First British man in three quarters of a century to win a Grand Slam. If you were watching that, you've missed a show put on by Joe Flacco, who's walked down the field 89 yards on a touchdown drive to put Baltimore back up 11. Five full possessions tonight, three touchdowns, one field goal for the Ravens. So Andy Dalton has to match that. He's going to go up against Lewis and the Raven defense. Teen seasons now. Tonight, age 37. Third linebacker to play 17 seasons, along with junior Seau, Clay Matthews, Lewis has 12 tackles, 9 of them unassisted.
It's the standard that he set here that impresses me the most. Every Raven that's come in here for 17 years has learned from the master, Ray Lewis.
A random burst of applause from the fans as they showed some Baltimore Orioles on the big screen. Dalton on the run, pass behind Andrew Hawkins and incomplete. Great tonight.
Well, he's made a lot of plays. There he is, scraping over the top. Nice tackle, little check down, open field tackle again. Those are hard tackles to make. When you're 27 or 37, you got to get off blocks and be productive. Ray Lewis is still getting it done.
Game number 223 in his career. Second and 10, low snap. Dalton scooped it out. Coverage was tight by Kerry Williams. And incomplete.
Little hook route. And Kerry Williams, who turned down a big contract offer, shows you why. He's an elite corner, I think, in the making. He's got size, had over 70 tackles last year. That's the second nice play he's made in a one-on-one situation.
Third down, Dalton. Pass is caught. What a job by Hawkins to keep the play alive. Still going, just shy of the 40. Ravens want him back 5 yards closer to the goal line, the 34, not out of the 40.
Well, you hear a lot of people say that's a football player. This kid is a natural football player. He knows exactly where Ray Lewis is, and he knows exactly where that first down strike is. Excellent effort.
There were a lot of things there. We had a challenge flag thrown, John. A penalty flag thrown. The Ravens are challenging the spot back there. And John Harbaugh will come over and talk to Richard Nix.
Baltimore's challenging the ruling on the field, saying that the runner was down by contact.
This is what Richard Nix will go under the hood and take a look at in replay. As Hawkins pivots and the knee goes down, is he touched by Ray Lewis while the knee is down? We'll look at it when we come back. At the 26-yard line, Ray Lewis buzzes up here in the coverage on Andrew Hawkins. Knee down, watch the hand, contacting him while the knee is down. It may be Ray Lewis's softest tackle, but it may be one of the bigger ones of the night, because it should give the ball on a punt back to Baltimore. Richard Nix has looked and has decided.
After further review, the runner was down at the 26. The ball would be placed at the 26-yard line, Cincinnati hash. The chains will be reset to the 20-yard line. Baltimore is not charged with a timeout. The clock will go on the ready.
So it'll be fourth and four in the punting unit right back out there with Kevin Huber ready to kick it away.
Excellent use of a challenge by head coach John Harbaugh.
He retains the opportunity to challenge twice more if need be. Jacoby Jones back deep to return. When Jones was here in the playoff game with the Texans, he had a couple of key mistakes, a muff and then a fumble that really hurt any hopes the Texans had of beating the Ravens. Still Baltimore side, but he's been a very good punt returner over the years. Returns this one 6 yards, brought down to the 25-yard line by Vontaze Burfict, the undrafted free agent, 57-yard punt. Well, tight ends, we talk about Gronkowski and Hernandez and Gresham. Dennis Pitt has had a big impact on the game here tonight for the Ravens. Touchdown on that last drive, John. Talk about the 2010, the tight end draft in the National Football League. Gresham was taken in the first round. Gronkowski, Hernandez by New England. Dixon and Pitta taken by Baltimore have also had a big impact. Let's not forget Moiaki and Jimmy Graham. Kansas City and New Orleans, respectively. Flacco down the seam. Oh, it's a tight end again. It's Pitta again. The Bengal territory with a gain of 25.
These receivers are just wide open. Every time the Ravens fake the ball to Ray Rice, the linebackers are gone. They're just going to fake the ball to Ray Rice, and everybody surges that way. No one's there for Dennis Pitta, who's leaking across the formation. Great design by Cam Cameron. Execution's been there all night.
48, Flacco with the pressure picked up. Sideline toss for Bolden. Ruled a catch. First down.
That's a hard thing to do. Come out of the break at full speed. Find the ball. It's in flight. And catch the ball with your fingertips on the sideline and get both feet in. It's a rare talent.
Leon Hall wanted no catch there. Bolden keeps the hand moving, the ball steady. The knee was down. Joe Flacco's closing in on 300 passing yards.
Shot time right here.
Play action to put it out to his other tight end. Dixon taken down dangerously. Jeremy Miles comes down and cuts him down. Gain of five.
Bengals have really struggled with bootlegs. Misdirection bootlegs. Fake the ball to Ray Rice. Come out with Joe Flacco on the edge of this defense. That time was a nice open field tackle.
You see that run pass selection. Only seven carries for Ray Rice here tonight. There's number eight. There's another first down.
This good double team at the point of attack. Right guard Marshall Yanda. There's an offensive guard you'd like to have on your football. Double team. Pull Marshall Yanda and run Ray Rice. How about that cut?
Yeah, John, Cam Cameron said no huddle. Ray Rice may not get as many carries. Doesn't mean he's going to touch the ball less. And still will be very impactful as the year goes on. Torrey Smith, trying to get him in space. A stiff arm gains him a couple more yards. Smith's in his second year out of Maryland, was a very good wide receiver, and really a old school blue collar approach that he brings, much like we're talking about A.J. Green on the other side and the other elite receivers, Larry Fitzgerald, Calvin Johnson. No more divas. We've got these guys who are the hard workers, the blue-collar guys who are team leaders as opposed to team distractions. Flacco, rocket shot towards Smith again.
You know, Torrey Smith, they just ran a double post right there. And Flacco's upset with himself because Torrey did an excellent job running down the corner. Newman's still fixing his helmet. But you're back to Torrey Smith, Mike. He shows all the characteristics of a go-to receiver. He's reliable. He can run all the routes. He's stronger. He loves it. A lot of talent.
Third and five, huge for the Bengals defense. Try to stay within 14. Flacco down the middle for the tight end Dixon. Defended by Nate Clemens and no flag.
Great play by Nate Clemens. There's a defender that Mike Zimmer wants to move around to get more involved in this secondary. They're going to play Clemens at safety. He's been a long-time corner. That time an excellent break on the ball. Touchdown saving play by the former Ohio State Buckeye.
It'll be a 40-yard field goal attempt for Justin Tucker. And he replaced Billy Cundiff. Good from 46 earlier. He was rock solid in the preseason. He made 6 and 7. His only miss was a 57-yarder. And it's 27-13, back to a 14-point edge.
You know, we've talked a lot about Joe Flacco tonight, Mike, but you have to really credit this young offensive line. We talked about it coming in here. They've made multiple changes. Michael Orr went to left tackle. Ramon Harewood playing left guard. They've done a nice job tonight.
And that was a significant area of concern, John. Now, you're talking about Bryant McKinney. Remember McKinney, of course, in the Minnesota Vikings. He was a Pro Bowler in Minnesota. And there were significant issues. Was he in shape? Contract issues. They were ready to release him. Matter of fact, McKinney had tweeted on Tuesday, I'm gone. Everybody thought he was going to be cut. But they reduced his salary cap number by $1 million, kept him. But you need to have guys who are in great shape to play this no huddle. And the players they've gone to have done a good job here tonight.
No question. The rookie right tackle, Kelechi Osemele, we haven't even talked about him. It's hard to be an offensive lineman in a no huddle offense. You have to not only be in shape, you have to be sharp. Because you don't get the play until 4 or 5 seconds before the ball is snapped. They've done a nice job blocking a very good Bengal defense. I give them a lot of credit.
So Baltimore team that won the division last year at 12-4. They swept the division. And they won their last 10 here at home. Brandon Tate wants to break a big return, but having none of it. Andy Dalton comes back out on the field. He replaced Carson Palmer, who held out and subsequently was traded to Oakland last year. Finally, a full training camp with the Raiders. We saw him a month ago, and they debut against the Chargers coming up next on Monday Night Football. It's the debut of Dennis Allen, the youngest head coach in the National Football League. Philip Rivers and the Chargers. Buck 13 left in the third. Then Jarvis Grinellis to the left, to the ground. Arthur Jones. He's become the other brother in the National Football League. His younger brother Chandler, first round pick of the Patriots. Big impact play that led to a Dante Hightower score yesterday in New England's win at Tennessee.
Yeah, Corey Redding, a very good defensive end, left, went to the Indianapolis Colts. That time, Arthur Jones showed that Baltimore Raven get off. Excellent backside pursuit.
Those two guys played at Syracuse. Their other brother, John Bones Jones, UFC light heavyweight champ. Tough family. Dalton second and nine's got space, taking a shot, double coverage. A.J. Green had the attention of the Ravens secondary and their safeties, Reed and Pollard.
That's just good football by Ed Reed and Pollard. The Bengals looking for a double move. And Ed Reed and Pollard stayed deep together. Two veteran safeties that have really worked well together. Hard to get a lot done in the middle of that defense.
His atmosphere has been fabulous tonight. These Ravens fans outstanding and standing much of the night. They bring five. Dalton gets rid of it. Too high. Intercepted. Ed Reed toward the end zone. Put it inside the pylon. Touchdown, Baltimore.
Flirting with disaster. You fall behind in the scoreboard. You fall behind in the down and distance. You're in a must-pass situation. The Ravens show pressure. Ball's tipped. And any time a ball is tipped in the middle of the field, Ed Reed will make you pay. 58 career interceptions. One of the all-time greats.
Gresham just got a fingertip on it. Reed caught it. Scoring play, so they wait for confirmation from upstairs as Reed, veteran, so knowledgeable, nose for the goal line, 13th touchdown he scored. Trying to bring the ball inside the pylon as he went to the goal line.
10 interceptions, Mike, against the Bengals, 10 against the Browns.
Take a look here at the back end of it. Stays inbounds, tries to sneak the ball inside the pylon. which is good, because once he's taken those steps inbounds, just break the plane with the ball, and you're all good. So a touchdown. And a lot of things on that Ed Reed touchdown, John. 58th pick. That ties Emmett Thomas. And Ed heading down to the Ravens locker room there. Ties Emmett Thomas for 10th all time in interceptions in the National Football League history. And he, 34 yards on that interception. And that means he breaks the record that Rod Woodson has held for the most interception return yards in NFL history. And he does it by 14 with that 34-yard takeback.
Had a great conversation with Ed Reed about the possibility maybe he wasn't going to come back. There was some noise that he was going to retire, maybe not continue playing football, spent some time. He's a very deep, critical thinker, this Ed Reed. And after the dust settled, he decides to come back, play one more year at least. I think this is the last year of his current contract, Mike.
Is John last year of a six-year deal. Is making $7 million this year. As they tend to his right leg there on the sideline. Ed talked with us about the passing of Junior Seau and how that hit close to him. And, you know, you leave your family. He's got a four-year-old son down in Atlanta. And Ed Reed spends a lot of time, obviously like all the players do, in the city where they play. He got home for the summer and the spring. He loved being back around his peeps, around his family. No return out of the end zone is Tate, so it's a touchback. Cincinnati ball at the 20.
Well, you're going to see a strong side blitz, and it's going to be a zone coverage, and Ed Reed just tracks the tight end, Gresham. But it's a blitz. It's a low-risk blitz zone coverage, and Ed Reed sees the quarterback the whole way. And this is what the Ravens have done very well over the years. I give defensive coordinator Dean Pease credit. Creative blitz. Quarterbacks under duress. You throw the ball under pressure against the zone defense with Ed Reed patrolling the middle of it. You got potential problems.
Two touchdowns in a minute and a game blown wide open. As Ed heads back to get worked on further, and another defensive back is hurt for the Ravens. Corey Graham on kick coverage there, being looked at by the Baltimore medical staff. Lisa Salter is down on the sideline. Lisa?
Hey, Mike, you just saw them take Ed Reed down the steps and back into the locker room. They're working on his right hamstring. They were working on it out here on the sideline for a little bit. They decided to take him to the back so they could work on it a little bit more.
Okay, thanks, Lisa. Corey Graham getting up and being helped off. John, to finish the conversation we were having with Ed Reed about coming back to football, because Ed has sent out those smoke signals over the last couple of off seasons. I don't know if he's going to come back. Most of the people around the Ravens were pretty sure he was coming back, but he did admit the passing of Seau, the time spent with family, that he kind of sees his football life down the end of the road here, and he's thinking about the next phase of his life and his career. So it'll be an interesting time to watch Ed Reed as he goes through this and any subsequent seasons, how often he thinks about stepping away from the game. Physically, he can still do it.
Got to just enjoy him while he lasts.
Dalton's pass complete. In a 21-point hole, it's the rookie Armon Benz to end the third quarter. Baltimore's offense kept scoring all night, putting the pressure on the Bengal offense. Ned Reed with the lead, made him pay one more time. 34-13, Baltimore.
That information with Sunday NFL Countdown, Sundays at 10 a.m. on ESPN.
Welcome down to Monday Night!
Season 43 of Monday Night Football. Fourth quarter begins. Mike Tirico, John Gruden, Lisa Salters with you in Baltimore. 17 in the first half, 17 in the third quarter for the Ravens. Webb coming. Webb hits Dalton. Pass knocked down. And incomplete. Nada gets credit for the deflection, but the pressure made it happen.
It's a stinger. Strong safety. Blitz. You got to be alert for the stingers coming off the edge. Dalton has seen it most of the night. This time with Darius Webb says, hello. You got to be looking on the edges all night if you're a left tackle or a right tackle. Baltimore loves to bring edge pressure.
After a good middle of the game, Dalton's just two of his last eight, including the pick six by Reed. Andy pulls it down, lost the football on the way down. Is it a fumble? Dalton in some pain as he took that hit trying to get the last 2 yards. It is a fumble, and the Ravens have it. Lardarius Webb comes up with the recovery.
A check on Dalton. Third down and two. They try to run a little option route. Ball's clearly out.
Ray Lewis.
You got to worry about Dalton's right shoulder there.
Ray Lewis punched it out. And the Ravens turn him over again.
Ken's Monday Night Football is brought to you by Snickers. You're not you when you're hungry. Snickers satisfies. The new 90-inch Aquas LED TV, only from Sharp and NFLShop.com. Get free shipping on orders today at the official store of the NFL.
Our aerial coverage tonight from Baltimore, brought to you by DirecTV. Joe Flacco first down, toss Ray Rice thinking about throwing. Now turns it upfield and runs and gets to the 21-yard line and a gain of seven. That turnover also saw a hit on Andy Dalton as Ray Lewis punched the ball out.
See Elodi Nada right there. Hey, look at that right shoulder.
Game of seven, Flacco up top to Torrey Smith. Flag down, pass interference call. We get Nate Clemens. It'll be first and goal for the Ravens.
A straight go route. That's pass interference.
Number 22 on the defense. Interference occurred in the end zone. By rule, the ball will be spotted on the 1 yard line. First down.
Ravens haven't got off the gas pedal, Mike. They run a halfback pass with Ray Rice. And a bomb here to start the fourth quarter. Joe Flacco in complete control of this football game.
Extra lineman Bryant McKinney in the game. Ray Rice. In for the touchdown.
Just a reverse pivot. Right behind Vontae Leach. Pro Bowl fullback. He's going to go right in here against number 51, Scuda. Backside guard, Marshall Yanda. Old school. 15 blast, we used to call it, Mike. Great pad level. Ravens have been tremendous on offense.
Two touchdowns for Ray Rice. Another team over 40 points in this opening week. Maybe the offense is ready to carry the Ravens and knock you down. Preseason, you know, Peyton Manning in the division, Kansas City getting healthy. 8-8, 9-7 is not going to do it. So every game really significant. Rivers and the Chargers take on the Raiders in Oakland. Chris Berman, Trent Dilfer, Rachel Nichols standing by for that game coming up next. Here on ESPN. These division games to start the year. Two close games with these teams. One score games won by the Ravens last year, 8-7. Not even close this year. I think he stepped out of bounds on the catch. He did. So Tate stops himself on the return. He'll take over at the 20-yard line. John, but really a tale of two halves. The first half, Andy Dalton handled the Ravens pressure. Early second half did okay, but since, been very poor.
Let me tell you, it's going to happen to a lot of quarterbacks this year if the Ravens can play offense like this. I don't remember the Ravens showing up and playing this kind of offensive football where they can score and take advantage of their defense and make you play from behind a very difficult thing to do.
Ravens have scored three touchdowns in the last 2 minutes and 9 seconds. Jermaine Gresham gets a gain of 12 yards.
I think the big statistic with John Harbaugh, the head coach of the Ravens, and Joe Flacco, the quarterback, since they've been here together in Baltimore, they're plus 32 in the turnover ratio. Mm-hmm. And there's only two teams better than Baltimore, and that would be New England and Green Bay. Tonight, they're plus 2. Huge statistic in winning is that plus ledger on the turnover battle.
Back to Gresham, tight end. And close to another first down as he's brought down. Jimmy Smith and Danelle Ellerby over there. But John, I asked you at the beginning of the game, that this Ravens team has been headlined by Ray and Ed, the future Hall of Famers, and Terrell Suggs, player of the year last year. So was the offense ready after a couple of years of buildup? This offense could be close. As you said, if tonight is an example of what they could be offensively, it does change it. Blitz wet, hits Dalton again, passing complete. And a flag comes down on the hit on Dalton.
It's a stinger again. A nickel fire right off the edge.
Andy took a shot in the ribs. Let's see. Official looked up
personal
the replay.
Foul. Unnecessary roughness on the defense. 15 yards. Automatic.
I just don't know what Ben Jarvis Green Ellis is looking at. You have to know that Ladarius Webb is a notorious blitzer in this scheme. Keep your eyes on a swivel, scan inside out, and never take your eyes off of Ladarius Webb when he's in there as the nickel corner.
John Harbaugh, very angry. When you saw it, the only thing that they could have called would be leading with his helmet on that play. And we get a timeout taken by Baltimore as the Ravens get their personnel organized here. 2 minutes into the fourth quarter. Very much in control, and Harbaugh to talk about the penalty with the referee. To let Richard Nix know he didn't like this call that was made. Jerry Seaman, long time, Jerry Seaman, listen to me. Jerry Austin next to us, long time NFL referee.
The quarterback's a defenseless player, and the defender comes in, lowers his head, and leads with his head, and hits the quarterback. That's a foul, always has been, still a foul.
And Jerry, the fans here in Baltimore are very disappointed by that, and it's not the lateness of the hit, it's the helmet part that would be called there.
That is correct.
Yeah. Frustrating for so many fans because big plays being made by the defense, but that is the way the league has gone with the rules, and the players all know that as well. After the Green Ellis run, Dalton has been taking a bunch of hits in this half, takes another one, slung down by Haloti Ngata at the 42.
Haloti Ngata, heavier than he's been the last couple years, had a thigh injury last year late in the season, missed the Pro Bowl. This time he's going to work with Zeitler. Looked like Andre Smith bumped him off. Haloti Ngata. Still a lot of firepower on this defensive team.
It's his second sack of the game. He only had 5 all last year. Playing that defensive tackle spot so well over the years. Lined up over the center on this play. And Dalton with nothing open just kills it and throws it in the ground.
That time he read the screen. They're going to try to throw a screen pass to Jermaine Gresham. And Haloti Ngata read that. You have a hard time blocking these up the field defensive tackles. You throw a screen pass. Well, this time Ngata, he just reads right out of the screen and covers the tight end. 3-time Pro Bowler. 350 pounds he is this year.
Says he's not going to wear down this year like last year.
I believe him.
Third and 23, screen Andrew Hawkins again. He's stopping a dime to get away from Paul Kruger, but he's brought down by Ellerby. Well short of the first down at the 31.
Good call. You try to get half of it back, get yourself in a convertible fourth down or field goal position, whatever Marvin Lewis decides. Looks like the Bengals will go for it. Fourth and 13. Ravens have made a living rushing three men in this situation. See if one of these big guys spies out of the charge.
Upshaw with a stunt. The rookie up the middle got picked up. Dalton, look out. Paul Kruger. Cornell McPhee. Courtney Upshaw. Add more names to the Ravens defense. The result remains the same. Season tonight.
I'll say, started on the first play of the game. He gets knocked down, and he throws a bomb to Torrey Smith. Then, fading away on his back foot, strike to Bolden for another score. Then the fadeaway to Dennis Pitta against a full blitz. He made all kind of throws tonight.
Bernard Pierce is coming as the running back, spelling Ray Rice. And a gain of a couple for the rookie out of Temple. And John, especially the throw to Bolden for the touchdown down the seam as he was going back. You said that in the highlight. I was sitting last night with Leon Hall and Nate Clemens, the veteran corners, and I said, how strong is Flacco? I said, yeah, strong, really? I said, well, is it Aaron Rodgers strong? He kind of looked at, no, Aaron Rodgers, he's kind of the benchmark for that strong arm. I said, Flacco's right there. Maybe not the same, but not too far behind. Throwing up 28. Throwing downfield and incomplete, intended for Dennis Pitta, the tight end, with Reggie Nelson, the safety, in coverage. So the Ravens score 41 tonight, John. It's the fifth team to score 40 or more points in their first game of the season, and that's in record. We haven't seen in their first games, that first week as we now know it, this many teams score over 40. I'm curious to get your thoughts about top and the bottom of that list. The Jets in the 48, they scored after they couldn't score essentially in the preseason. And then RG3 putting up 40 along with the Redskins in New Orleans. Pressure on Flacco and he goes down. Geno Atkins, the Pro Bowler from the year ago, comes up with a sack.
I just don't understand why the Ravens are still throwing. I mean, I know they want to make a statement tonight, but they've made their statement with Flacco. That time, Geno Atkins came through clean and hammered Flacco. Valuable piece of property right there, Joe Flacco.
Second punt of the game coming up. I couldn't agree with you more. You know, you're asking for them to keep rushing the passer. You're asking for your quarterback to get hurt in what would be a foolish situation. You're up 28 with 10 minutes left. Not asking you to take a knee, but, you know, be smart about this. Brandon Tate from the 10. Nice return from Tate. An even better tackle on a 15-yard bring back. He's brought down by Anthony Allen, who's just signed off the practice squad today by the Ravens. Well, he said he was healthy all summer. Antonio Gates said he ran routes like he hasn't in 2 years preparing for this season. We'll see if the perennial Pro Bowler holds up as the Chargers and Raiders kick off. That kick time has been moved now to 10:25 Eastern, 7:25 in Oakland. So you should get that game right from the beginning. And if we're still going at 10:25 Eastern, it'll start over on ESPN2. We'll get you there as soon as this one's over. On the clock, that is. Outcome not in doubt with the Ravens up 28. Armand Bins, the catch to the 32. And John, this is blowout time in some regards. This is very important time for your brother Jay and his receiving core, because there are a lot of guys who are playing in their first national.
No question. And you want to see your team compete in any situation. I'm sure Marvin Lewis, Jay Gruden, Mike Zimmer are all looking at the same thing.
Ryan Leonard on the run. Stopped by Arthur Jones. It's Bins, Marvin Jones, on Marvin Lewis's team, a rookie out of Cal. Mohamed Sanu, the rookie out of Rutgers. Those are the other receivers we've seen. Andrew Hawkins, who proved it at the end of last year, we've seen he's a real deal slot impact guy.
Well, Jerome Simpson, Andre Caldwell, two veterans are gone. These young players are who they're going with, and they're going to have to step up, take advantage of the playing time.
Third and two. Well, Ford Gresham is broken up. Darius Webb has had a very good game. Called him a lot, along with Jameel McClain, to force another three and out.
A lot of tip passes tonight, particularly in the second half. That time it's Webb again, coming off the strong side edge. Nice three and out by the Ravens.
Fumble recovery, seven tackles for Webb. Goes back to get the Kevin Huber punt. And call for the fair catch at the 19-yard line. Oh, next week, what a showdown we have on Monday night in the Georgia Dome as Peyton Manning off that tremendous effort by the Broncos against the Steelers. We'll visit Matt Ryan, and his offense was even more impressive in Kansas City. Broncos, Falcons, 1 week from tonight in Atlanta. Monday Night Countdown gets us started at 6:30 Eastern Time. Joe Flacco's night is done. He's shy of a 300-yard passing night. And Tyrod Taylor, the second-round pick out of Virginia Tech, has come in the game. Second year, sixth round, he was taken. Did a great job during his years in Blacksburg. School record 34 wins. Bernard Pierce with a run, taken down by Nate Clements. I know a lot of your fantasy football games come down to what the Monday night guy does. Joe Flacco couldn't get you another yard for 300. That's the only thing bad you can say about his night. He was terrific. Hey, look at the other leaders for Baltimore this evening.
They spread the ball around extremely well, and they use personnel. I saw three receiver sets with Bolden, Torrey Smith, Jacoby Jones, two tight ends. Here you see that again with a tight end in the backfield. A lot of good stuff tonight from Baltimore.
Taylor handing to Anthony Allen. You mentioned Allen was signed off the practice squad just today. Bobby Rainey was the third back. He was very similar, clone to Ray Rice. They were calling him Mini Rice around the Ravens, and he was released and waived today as they brought Allen, a little bit more experienced second year out of Georgia Tech, to the active squad.
Surprised me. I was calling you in the middle of the night telling you about Bobby Rainey. I love to watch the Ravens in the preseason because we all know Ozzie Newsome, the general manager, does a great job not only drafting but signing undrafted free agents.
And Rainey was that out of Western Kentucky. Was the Sun Belt Offensive Player of the Year back-to-back seasons. As Allen carries out the 42-yard line.
This is what's disappointing right now if you're a Bengal fan is the surge that you're seeing. The Raven offensive line is coming off the ball and knocking white jerseys backwards. It's an obvious running situation. The Bengals somehow got to find enough inside of them to stop the run.
Cincinnati goes home Sunday. They open their season with Cleveland. A difficult back end of the schedule. The part where they need to take advantage is the early part. Allen is stopped again.
Good play there by Domata Peko, leader of this Bengal defense. I know he's going to fly back to Cincinnati with his teammates. Not be at all happy with tonight's performance, but important for a lot of teams that are going to be 0-1 after the first week of the season. Regroup. Try to find a win next week against the Cleveland Browns.
Here's Taylor. Dumping it to Vontae Leach in the flat. And Nelson goes low to bring him down. They brought in Curtis Painter. Take a look at the number two spot this year in preseason. Painter did perform well at start in Indianapolis last year, but they felt more comfortable with Taylor to go with him as the backup, ACC Player of the Year. Every year took Virginia Tech to bowl games, set records. Came out of that Hampton, Virginia area where Michael Vick came out of, went to Virginia Tech. Taylor followed that path. Offensive coordinator Cam Cameron was effusive last year in his praise of Tyrod Taylor and his pinpoint accuracy. Breaking out of the tackle, Deontay Thompson. First NFL catch for the rookie out of Florida who caught over 100 passes. And John, like you said, free agents out of college. Signed by the Ravens.
And this kid can run. Great quick blitz picked up. And the ball's thrown well by Tyrod Taylor. And well, there's a rap on a lot of kids. They don't run fast. They're not big enough. They said Deontay Thompson can't catch the ball well enough. He had an excellent preseason. He really showed off his speed during the preseason, and right there he shows you he can catch and he can run with it afterwards.
Deontay Thompson was on the Gators track team when he got to Gainesville.
I look out there in the huddle. This fullback, Vonte Leach, he's the only man in the NFL that started 16 straight games at fullback. It's a dying breed, Mike. Not a lot of teams use a fullback. He started all 16 games. He started tonight, played over 650 snaps. He gives the Ravens a physical presence about him. They already had that with Ray Lewis, Ed Reed, Nada, all those defensive players. But Leach, he brings it to the offensive side of the ball. He's like to go in there and have to get off of that block all night.
Taylor rolling to his left towards that Bengals sideline. He'll slide down at the 20-yard line. Now, John, I looked up and I saw Matt Burke on the sideline for the Ravens. I see the center in there is 66. That's a rookie making his NFL debut tonight, Gino Gradkowski.
Yeah.
And the name sounds familiar. He is the brother of Bruce Gradkowski, NFL quarterback who you had.
Yeah, he's and over there with the Bengals.
He's the backup for the Bengals. So what a throw it is for Gino Gradkowski. Make your NFL debut on Monday Night Football. You get to play, and you're going up against your brother's team. A great night for the Gradkowski family.
There's Bruce. He's a great kid. I called Bruce last night. I said, Gino got all the looks in this family. Bruce recently buried. He's a good, solid backup quarterback and real ally for Andy Dalton.
Third and three. Taylor sees pressure, lofting it up to Thompson. He didn't come down in bounds as Leon Hall sent him down. Incomplete.
Full blitz that time. Tyrod read it. Got the ball out of his hand early enough. Gave Thompson a chance to play it. No such thing as a force out anymore. At least that's one rule I still understand. Jerry.
You are Mr. Rules now, dude. See, you're hanging out with an official. You've become
been a big help to me.
The rules expert.
He really has.
It's been a good debut for Justin Tucker to this point. It continues here with a 39-yard field goal. So he made a 46, a 40, a 39, and he's got six touchbacks on kickoffs as he replaces Billy Cundiff and takes it up to 44-13. Well, both of these teams in this division have tough schedules. Already Andy Dalton knocked off by the Ravens. Dalton went to the Pro Bowl. Here are the other Pro Bowl quarterbacks on the slate. Michael Vick next week. Then Brady the week after that. It's very difficult open for the Ravens. There's very little respite. Castle, Romo, Matt Schaub await three consecutive weeks. On through the latter part of the season. Obviously the division rivalries with Roethlisberger and the Steelers twice in 3 weeks. And the two quarterbacks you're going to see next, Peyton on the slate for week 15, Eli Manning, the Super Bowl winning quarterback, and they'll bookend the season with matchups against the Bengals.
You know what I don't hear? I don't hear the Ravens shaking in their boots, do you?
Well,
they'll be there. I guarantee you, the Ravens will be there. They're not worried about any of those pictures you just showed.
Well, you go up against the Raven defense, it makes it a little bit more difficult. And we show all those quarterbacks. Here's the best news if you're a Raven fan tonight. Your quarterback belongs as, boy, we got to play Flacco in that offense in the mindset of others.
In a no-huddle offense. Mm-hmm. And they've gone no-huddle tonight with three wideouts on the field, two wideouts on the field, two tight ends. I don't know how they've done it, but it's a credit to what they've done in the offseason. They took advantage of the time spent together.
This will be a returnable kick for Brandon Tate. And he gets past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Well, the one thing the Raiders never had last year as they got ready was Darren McFadden and Carson Palmer together on the field. They'll start the season. We'll see the impact that that has as Dennis Allen starts his head coaching career. Raiders, Chargers coming up next.
McFadden, you know, the Raiders haven't had a Pro Bowl running back since Bo Jackson. McFadden stays healthy, he'll be the next one.
255, and now the other Gradkowski. I don't think Bruce has been called that very often in his pro football career, but Bruce Gradkowski steps in, hands it off to Jim Leonard. Gradkowski, who was with Oakland in 09 and 10, started four games in each of those seasons. Set some high school records in Western Pennsylvania, and that says a lot. The great pedigree of quarterbacks over the years in Western PA.
Get your rookies some playing time. Orson Charles at tight end. Zeitler still in there at right guard. A number of rookies out there at the skill positions.
Cedric Pierman gets a carry. Five in his NFL career. Takes that out by the 30 and will take us to the two-minute warning. It was tight through the early third quarter. And the Ravens offense moved it down the field. The Ravens defense, see if they keep it going next Monday night with Peyton Manning and the Broncos in Atlanta to take on the Falcons. Quite a comeback moment last night. Third and one. Gradkowski almost lost the handoff. Cedric Pierman gets the first down out to the 43-yard line. The numbers that Peyton Manning and Matt Ryan put up, John, yesterday. No picks, five touchdowns. Matty Ice ran one in.
Total control of their offenses. Both of them you're going to see in a no-huddle offense. An array of different formations, personnel groupings. Two quarterbacks at the top of their game. Can't wait.
Kirk Cutter, the new coordinator in Atlanta. Love the look of their offense as they got started. Pierman jumps out there to the 45-yard line. So, John, this will be very similar to last year's opening for the Ravens. 35-7 was the score they beat Pittsburgh week one. They'll win by similar margin here, up 31. They won that game by 28. And it's the fifth straight year that the combination of Harbaugh and Flacco have opened with a win. As has been mentioned, they've made the playoffs all 4 years together. Lost the snap. Gradkowski gets it back as he was hit by James Ahedibo, who they just signed here this week, and that should be the last play of the game. 44-13. It was 17-13. About 9 minutes left in the third quarter, and then the Ravens went on a drive, made some game-changing plays, and the T-shirt underneath John Harbaugh's Ravens shirt there is a picture of Art Modell's face and some of the accomplishments of the late owner of the Ravens on the back of that T-shirt. You see Ray Lewis wearing one there. Almost all the Ravens have those on under their gear. And there's a wonderful career of Art Modell, which was commemorated and remembered before the game. Ends tonight with a season-opening win for Baltimore, 44-13.
I believe I...
And Lisa Salters is standing by with Joe Flacco. Lisa?
Joe, you told me before the game that you were not going to take your foot off the gas pedal this season. What was working tonight with the offense?
Yeah, I think we were, we had a little miscommunication here and there that we need to work on and get set. But, you know, we were able to keep the tempo up for the most part. I think that was huge for our offensive linemen and their matchups. And, late in the game, in that third quarter, we started getting some pretty good chunks down the field, and it really worked out well.
What was the miscommunication early?
A couple plays, just here and there that we could probably get signaled to each other better, and a couple miscues that, probably ended up resulting in field goals. We actually scored on one of the drives that we had a couple miscues on, but it's just little things that we can work on to improve next week.
You talked a lot about the no huddle. What impact did it have tonight?
I think it was big. I mean, these guys are guys that can get after the passer big time. And, you know, we really found that out 2 years ago. And I think when you talk to our linemen, they'll tell you that it was huge, just the effect it had on those guys and how much it took away that real sense that they could get after us.
A touchdown pass to Anquan Boldin. Take me through that.
Is that which one was that? What happened on that?
Your
oh, yeah, okay. So we had a little route on the backside, and I came back, and he was my second progression up the seam, and I only got to look at him for a split second because somebody came out the middle and hit me, but I knew he was one-on-one. I knew the safety was kind of lost on the other side of the field, so I knew I could give him a shot to go up and get it.
Thanks, Joe, and congratulations on the win. Mike?
You know your night was good, and you threw some good passes when you have to go, which one was that? It was the one to Bolden. Oh, that one down the seam. We'll be back to wrap it up here in Baltimore and get you out to Oakland for the Chargers and the Raiders on Monday Night Football.